it is Vanna from Cheap Nails, helping you stay frugal with nail art. And in this video, I'm going to be doing a natural nail at-home manicure. So let's get started. Before you start this, you definitely want to remove all of your old polish that you might have on your nails, because we're starting new and fresh. If you want to see a video on how to remove nail polish, you can click up in the I button in the corner. After I removed my old polish, this might be surprising, but I like to start out with a nail remedy. Today, I'm going to be using honey, which is so good for your nails because it's got natural vitamins. It is a great moisturizer. It really moisturizes your nail bed and your skin. I mean, honey, man, I know it's a little sticky, but if you get past the sticky, it's just great. And also, it doesn't, like, bacteria can't really breed in it, so it kind of disinfects your nails and your hands because, you know, we're all trying to keep our hands clean right now. So I'm gonna go ahead and rub that in and leave it to soak. Well, not soak, but be on my nails for 15 to 20 minutes. Once the time is up, I'm just gonna go ahead and take my nails and just wash them with plain water because I don't want to use any kind of soap because that could dry out my nail bed. And yes, all of the stickiness is gone, just plain water. Yeah, take it away. After I do this little routine with honey, my nails and skin feel so soft. So let's move on to the next step, which is cuticle remover. I'm gonna be using my Blue Cross cuticle remover. I'm gonna go to grab my metal cuticle pusher, but I suggest if you're a beginner, just use a orange wood stick because it's a lot softer on the nails. So I'm gonna go ahead and put one drop of the cuticle remover on my nails, and then I'm gonna take my metal cuticle pusher. Metal cuticle pushers are a lot, like, kind of more rough on the nail, so you gotta be a little more gentle when you're pushing it back so it, you don't, like, hurt. You know, one time I kind of slipped and I kind of cut my cuticle, so yeah. Be careful when you're using a metal cuticle pusher. Okay, after I push back my cuticles, because pushing back your cuticles is really important, if you want a professional looking manicure, like an awesome looking manicure, you definitely want to use cuticle remover. Now I noticed that they raised the price on a lot of the cuticle removers, and I'm like not okay with that. I'm like, what's going on here? This Blue Cross cuticle remover, I paid $4.99 for it on Amazon, and they just raised the price to, like, I don't know, like $9.99. What's going on there? Okay, after I do that, I'm gonna take my cotton swab and some vinegar and clean my nail. Vinegar is a great cleaner, you know, to clean off all that dead skin from the nail and prep it and dehydrate it all ready for the nail polish. So I'm gonna go ahead and wipe them off now, and they're gonna feel really clean. If you use vinegar, they're gonna feel really clean because vinegar is just an awesome thing. I always use vinegar to clean my nails. Okay, we're moving on to base coat. Yeah, we're on a base coat. I'm gonna be using this Wet n Wild dollar base coat. It works pretty good. And we're gonna put one coat of that on our nails and let that fully dry. I know this is a lot of steps before we actually get to paint our nails, but it's totally worth it. Definitely have to prep the nail properly so our manicure lasts a long time so we can fully enjoy it. You can't really enjoy a manicure if you paint it and then, you know, kind of chips off or something. Then you're kind of just looking at the chip and you're like, it gets really annoying. So we definitely want to prep our nails right so it lasts as long. Also, if I get on my skin, I just take my toothpick and just wipe it right off. Okay, after our base coat is fully dry, this is the exciting part. We pick the polish that we want to paint our nails. I am picking this Salon Perfect, and I've never actually used Salon Perfect. This is my first Salon Perfect. It is called Ballet Slippers, which I love the name, so I just had to get it. I've never tried one of these polishes. They're like $3.89 at Walmart. That's a little more expensive than my dollar polishes, so I wanted to try it out and see how it goes. So I'm gonna go ahead and paint one coat of that on my nails. Now, I really like the Salon Perfect formula. I think it's really nice, and this definitely represents ballet slippers. Let me tell you, it's right with the name. But the flat brush, you know, like, it's kind of skinny. I really prefer more bigger brushes, like wide flash brushes, not really skinny ones. But I gotta say, this formula performed really well. I really like how easy it was to apply, and I almost got, like, full coverage in the first coat, but I definitely, of course, I always go in with a second coat. And if I get any on my nails, I just take the toothpick and just wipe it right off. I get kind of messy sometimes when I'm painting. Here is a closer look, and this is the method I use to paint my nails. I usually start a little bit away from the cuticle, and then I push up, and then I move side to side. This is how I paint my nails every time. It's kind of unfailing. I really like painting the sides of my nails, but sometimes I kind of go a little overboard and get polish on my skin. But then it's okay, because before it dries, I just grab a toothpick and I just swipe it right off. After I've painted the first coat of polish on, I wait 15 minutes, and then they're usually fully dry by 15 minutes, depending on the polish, and the humidity, because I know if it's humid outside, my nail polish takes forever to dry. But here, I waited 15 minutes and it was dry, so I went in with the second coat. And as you see, I'm applying the second coat and it is fully opaque. Yeah, fully opaque, two coats, isn't that awesome? I really like when polishes are fully opaque in two coats, because I usually only do two coats of nail polish. And also remember, don't be too hard on yourself if you like paint on your skin or something, because it happens, you know? You can just clean it up later. Practice makes progress, and as long as you practice a lot, you'll be able to paint your nails perfectly. Alrighty, I got two coats on and it's fully opaque, so let's go ahead and move on to top coat. I'm gonna be using this Sally Hansen Miracle Gel top coat. Now, I really like this top coat because it's nice and thick, and when you're doing a manicure, you want to kind of like mimics gel, you know? It's not exactly gel, but it's kind of like a thick, nice top coat. So I'm gonna go ahead and apply that to all of my nails. I love using quick dry top coat, and this top coat does dry very quickly, which is great, because trust me, you don't want to be doing your nails and not using a quick dry top coat, because you gotta wait forever for them to dry, they're gonna smudge. Like, you just need a quick dry top coat. So definitely, if you're doing your manicures, make sure you got quick dry top coat. I really like this Sally Hansen. I was gifted with it, so I don't know exactly what the price is on it, but it's a very good top coat. If I get some of the top coat on my skin, I just take the toothpick and just kind of wipe it off. Putting top coat on is so important, and it's pretty much the last step of my manicure, but we can't forget moisturizing. I'm going to be using extra virgin olive oil to moisturize my nails, because you definitely want to moisturize them after you do them. Now, wait till your nails are completely dry before you moisturize them, because you don't want to mix like wet top coat and olive oil together. That wouldn't be good. And after I moisturize them, my manicure is fully done, and I think my nails came out beautifully. So that is my manicure routine. I really like starting off with some kind of natural nail remedy, and then I go ahead and remove my dead skin and push back my cuticles with using cuticle remover. Then I clean my nails, then I put base coat on, and then I paint, and then a top coat, and then I apply natural oil. I am very happy with this routine, because I can usually get my manicure to last up to 2 weeks, which is great. If you got value out of this video, please hit the like button and subscribe down below if you want to see more content. And thank you so much for watching this video, and I will see you next Friday. Bye! P.S. Please follow me on Instagram, because I post awesome pictures and we can DM each other. So yeah, go follow me over there.